Let's talk about John Calvin in regard to the Presbyterians. John Calvin is often thought of as the main guy in the Presbyterian Church, the big daddy, the big kahuna, and he is the founder of the Presbyterian Church. And if we look at a little bit about Calvin, we see he's a 16th century French scholar. He was a trained attorney of his day, and he turned his skill with the law and with thinking in that way toward the Reformation that was going on. He was followed after Martin Luther, and he was a second generation reformer. They were trying to reform the Roman Catholic Church. Now, if you think of the word Protestant, it forms two words, protest and ant. Protest, ant. So these were little ants that were protesting against the Catholic churches, the Protestants. When Calvin published his Institutes of the Christian Religion in 1536, it kind of put him on the map as a player in the Reformation. He had been and studied and learned what he needed to know to be a primary thinker in the Protestant Reformation. So here's the church in Geneva where Calvin preached. He was sort of the mayor of Geneva back in that time. He was preaching here, and he was calling the shots in the city. And if you didn't attend worship, well, you might want to watch your back, because you could be severely punished. It was a no frills and no holds barred attempt to follow God and live a righteous life as they understood it to be in that day. Calvin really presented the Presbyterian form of government. It was a different way of doing church, so that it wasn't a top-down way. It was where the people elected elders who then ruled the local church, making 99% of the decisions for the rest of the church. And these elders of the local church would join together with other Presbyterian churches in the area, and they would form a presbytery made up of dozens of different churches in the area, or however many there are in that area. Think of a presbytery as maybe like a county. And then beyond that, you have the synod, which would be all the Presbyterian churches, let's say like in three or four different states of the United States, if we translate it to today. So if the local church is like the local city council, then the presbytery would be like the county council. And then the synod would be like three or four different states put together. And then the general assembly is the entire United States, let's say, all the Presbyterians of this particular denomination within the whole nation. So at each different level, you have representatives being elected to go and serve at the next higher governing body level, from local church to presbytery to synod to general assembly. So here's some photos. On the left is the birthplace of John Calvin. And then upper right is the school he built in Geneva. Presbyterians have been people of education and who believe in education. We've been instrumental in establishing public education in the United States and many colleges, including Princeton University and many other colleges throughout the United States. And then in the bottom right, you have a picture of Geneva, Switzerland. So this is just a little taste of John Calvin. He's not really worshipped or adored in the Presbyterian Church, but he is the founder who laid the foundational documents, sort of gave us some good books that interpret the Bible, called commentaries, and then some good theological books, such as Institutes of the Christian Religion, that help us understand the theology of what the Scripture is saying and how we should interpret it and live our lives. So that's a bit about John Calvin and the Presbyterian Church.